guys, welcome to this interesting episode today at Oh Mind Your Body, where we're going to talk about plant-based diets. What is a plant-based diet? What are the problems or usually where people get stuck with plant-based diets? Let's address them today. And welcome everyone. I hope you all had an amazing Diwali, amazing vacation, amazing everything. I am very, very happy and refreshed after my vacation that I took. We didn't come last week live because we all thought that we all just need a little break. So we are coming back today with another interesting series on Oh Mind Your Body with our dietitian Riya Doshi, who is the founder and owner at Yellow Bowl. Also, thank you guys for joining in. Thank you, Forum. Thank you, Kanika. Thank you guys for joining in. Also, I would really like to say that we are doing a 21-day challenge, guys. We just launched it yesterday, where we have started the challenge today. Me and Riya Doshi, Yellow Bowl and Oh Mind Your Body have come together and started a 21-day challenge where we are monitoring everything. We are giving you diets. We are giving you some healthy and tasty recipes. So it's a combination of diet and lifestyle change with exercises as well. So please, if you are interested, you can DM us. We can enroll you to our next program that starts. And apart from that, thank you, Shell. Thank you guys for joining in. Let's get our dietitian on board, dietitian Riya Doshi. And let's get addressing to these important questions that we get stuck when switching to plant-based diets. So, yes, thank you so much, guys. Really, thanks a lot for joining in. Hi, Riya.
Hi. How are you? I'm good. Good evening. How are you?
Good evening. I'm doing awesome. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. Hectic.
Yeah, I can understand. Yeah, I think the challenge that we've launched, we just started today, is asking for a lot of time and attention. And I'm sure we are putting in 100% to get the maximum results for people.
But you know what? I'm really loving the engagement that it takes. And I'm very thrilled to see people very excited about the whole thing. So that gives a lot of energy, right?
Absolutely right. So let's get started with our series of plant-based diets.
And yes, get it up.
What is a plant-based diet, Riya, exactly?
So a plant-based diet basically is something which involves food from the sources of plants. Okay? Like, like your cereals, like your rice, your jawar, bajri, your wheat. There are grains, right? So they come from your plant source. Your dals, okay, your moong, makki, chana, your pulses, your vegetables, your salads, okay? So anything, your oil for that matter, okay? The oil, the cooking oil that we use is all categorized under plant-based diets. Even your herbs and spices that we get is all categorized under plant-based diets. And under a plant-based diet, there is one thing where, you know, minimally processed food is had. It's a special diet, okay? Rather, I would say that this is a lifestyle that many of them have actually adopted. And they have found astonishing results, okay? So, yeah. So, in short, this is plant-based diet where minimally processed food, something which is natural, something which is close to nature and, if possible, organic, okay, that is pesticide-free, okay. So that thing comes under plant-based diet.
Perfect. So let's get to our next question where we are going to address, Riya, what is exactly the major difference between a plant-based diet and a vegan diet?
Yeah, so this question always comes to me, okay, and people get really scared with vegans, okay, and then there are so many questions that comes for vegans. So the only difference between a plant-based diet and vegans are that vegans do not use anything which is animal products, okay. So they like, for example, they don't use things made from leather. That is your purses, your shoes, your belt. So Yes, people do not use the vegans completely abandon or ban rather the use of animal products, whether it is in your eating or whether it is in your usage. So that's the only difference. The plant-based people who follow plant-based, they basically do sometimes have use the animal products. Okay, so the usage is there. Of course, they do not eat it, they do not consume it, but yes, the usage is there.
Very, very well addressed. So we can say that vegetarian and plant-based diet is not the same, clearly, because vegetarians do use milk and milk products, which are a part of the animals.
Yes. And when you say vegetarian, processed food, packet foods, all these foods, they come into picture. So they are included. So of course, vegetarian and plant-based, they're completely, I mean, you can easily categorize them. There is
Your
a
voice is
difference.
breaking, Ria.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Is
Okay.
it okay now?
Yeah, let's see. Okay. So yeah.
Yes.
So basically, I would like to ask over here, is that in a plant-based diet, do we use processed foods or not?
So as I just said that we use very minimal amount of processed, absolutely very very close to nature. In fact, I would like to say the amount of oil that is used in a plant-based diet is also very minimal. Okay, so yes, of course it is used, but as in vegetarian diet, like there is a clear category of vegetarians and non-vegetarians, and vegetarians keep eating junk also. They do eat they do eat processed food, they eat canned foods, all right, but the plant-based, the people on plant-based diet, they clearly have a restriction to it. Some
Okay.
people go oil-free, they make oil-free cooking. They go a step ahead, the ones on the plant-based. So yes. So as I said, food in its very natural form, okay, very closer natural form, they prefer that. So that is what plant-based diet is all about.
Perfect. So let's go to our next question is what foods are plant-based diets?
So as I just said, in the introduction, that anything that comes from your plant source, your nuts, your dry fruits, your oil seed, your dals, your cereals, your grains, your fruits, your salads, your any vegetable, spices, herbs, they are categorically, they come under plant-based diet. Okay. Also your oils. Okay. And generally plant-based, the people on plant-based, okay, they prefer cold pressed extra virgin oil, okay, as the other oil that everyone uses is processed or refined. So yes, so food in its natural form, where the food vibrates a lot of energy, okay, when you consume, you vibrate a lot of energy, and that's very evident from your health. Those food categorically comes under plant-based.
Perfect. I think very well addressed, Priya. So we would like to address why is it gained so much of popularity suddenly? You have any say on this?
Yes, and I would like to say why. Okay, I will tell you. Sudden popularity. So this plant-based diet has been practiced since ages, I'm telling you. Okay, but it has gained sudden popularity because, okay, people who were strict non-vegetarians, okay, they swore by their non-vegetarian food, they suddenly switched because of some health reason or because of the awareness or knowledge of the benefits of plant-based, they suddenly switched on to a plant-based diet, and they saw amazing benefits. So moreover, eminent personalities, okay, your cricketers, your film stars, when they do this, okay, they themselves inspire a lot. They are role models to so many, and they start inspiring automatically by default. So that is one reason why it has gained. Another reason is there are many researches going on, many researches going on through, I would say, decades, okay, and finally it has got its due respect. in the world of nutrition. Okay, finally, we have seen there is a lot, you know, it has really been helpful. Well, I'll talk about it. It has been really helpful in reversing so many diseases. And there were mind-blowing experiences when one is on a plant-based nutrition, okay, a diet. And that is the reason. And the benefits are so classic, okay, they are so different. It has attracted a lot of attention because of that. You know, apparently that's the reason. There's a squeaky noise somewhere.
Now?
Not now. Oh, okay. Why is that honking?
So, what are the benefits of going on a plant-based dietary? If you could guide us through on that more in detail.
See, the benefits are immense. And I'll tell you one thing. People who are vegetarian and switch over to plant-based, rather than that, people who are non-vegetarian and directly switch over to plant-based, there is a remarkable difference. Okay? And people have been studied on this for, you know, for few months. They have been studied for few years. And they have seen amazing results. Now, let me go into the depth of the results. Okay. And whatever I'm mentioning right now, this is not my experience. These are all research-based information that I'm going to give you. Okay. There are many numbers. I'm not mentioning the numbers here because it's very confusing. But let me tell you, all these benefits, okay, absolutely, they are researched. Okay. The first and the foremost benefit of being on a plant-based diet is that your basal metabolic rate, that is your BMI, your body weight decreases and your metabolism increases. So someone who's trying to lose weight, they should really seriously try considering going, you know, on a plant-based diet, because milk is eliminated from that, okay? And most of the Indians or most of the human beings, milk is not being tolerated. So once they go off that, you know, it becomes very easy to lose weight because the entire microbial flora, the bacteria, the good bacteria that helps us digest food, they basically change. Okay. Now this lovely atmosphere that it creates by through a plant-based diet, okay, it helps in
reverse. Let me cut you here. Your voice is breaking a lot in your video.
Again?
A lot stuck. Actually, voice breaking हो रहा है पर video घड़ी घड़ी stuck हो रहा
है. Uh oh. Okay. I don't know why. One second, I'll just.
Because your voice is there, but your video is getting stuck again and again.
All right.
Thank you,
is
Banu.
This okay?
Thank you guys for joining in. I mean, अभी तक तो ठीक है. जैसे ही होता है, देखती हूँ, बताती हूँ.
Yeah. अभी ठीक है?
हाँ जी, हाँ, so go ahead, plant-based diets के benefits.
Yeah, so benefits. The first is your weight loss. So someone who's seriously trying to lose weight, okay, and is a strict, hardcore non-vegetarian, or someone who's a vegetarian, okay, and is having a lot of dairy in their food. Is it okay? You want me to log in again? I think that should be better.
Yeah, I think.
I'll log in again.
So yes, guys, we had some internet issues from the Yellow Bowl. So they're going to join us back. Meanwhile, you can ask me any interesting questions if you all have regarding the plant-based diet or anything regarding the topic. If you all want me to address anything in specific, please ask me. I will get it addressed, get it answered. And until then, I'm so glad that you guys have joined. Thank you guys for joining in and for being such a beautiful and lovely audience. I can't thank you enough. Thanks a lot. And yes, so tell me what else is going on in your life, guys. Are these live sessions working for you all? Are you liking it? You can mention in the comment section, and we have Yellow Bowl together with us. Let's get bored with her. And let's get starting to address all our questions. Yes, Tim, go ahead.
I really hope I'm audible now. Okay. And there's no disturbance, right? So so I was talking about weight. Okay, now let me come to another biggest benefit is metabolic disorders. Today, the generation of today, our population, okay, this Gen X, I'm the Gen X, we all completely, we follow or we go through a very major issue, which is a metabolic disorder. What is metabolic disorder? Obesity comes under metabolism. So your metabolism is hampered. So obesity, your diabetes, okay, PCOD, PCOS, thyroid. You see the increasing cases these days, okay? Now, this metabolic disorder could be effectively reversed if your case is new, okay? If you've just been diagnosed by a metabolic disorder. Okay, even diabetes, you can rest assured that it can be reversed. All right, so this one, and I have seen people doing extremely well. People whose sugar levels weren't coming down, okay, they were not dropping down. I have seen people going on plant-based, actually, reversing that. The third major factor is that, there is less hormones going inside your body, because when you see milk has a lot of, is infused, our milk that you get today is infused with a lot of hormones. Okay, these hormones are not good for us. Okay, it's for cow and to produce more milk. And imagine that is going in your milk and milk is going in your body. And as it is, we do not have that enzyme to digest the milk. So imagine the havoc, the hormonal havoc that it creates. All right. And so that is the reason, switching over to plant-based diet gives immense benefit to all the people having hormonal havoc. Okay. Another, these days we are very, very concerned about the toxic load that happens due to the amount of non-veg that we have. Okay, the non-vegetarian food, okay, leaves, the protein metabolites or the remains of it, which are not very easily thrown out of our body. Okay, but imagine if you're not having that, it takes a very long time to digest. And so the stomach, the body has to really work, 10 to 20 times more than the required amount. All the energy is diverted there to digest. But imagine if you're on a plant-based diet. The atmosphere of your bacteria is such that it digests everything. Not only that, whatever vitamins and minerals, the nutrients that you have, okay, the environment is created in such a way inside your gut that the nutrition absorption is much higher than on a vegetarian diet or than on a non-vegetarian diet. Are you getting me? So this is just the start point when you start switching over. And then very gradually you'll see a very great difference in that. We talk about cardiovascular diseases. Cholesterol drops down to 30% in just going 3 months on plant-based diet. Okay? You can control your high blood pressure. Okay? There are cases where, the arteries have been clear, been on a plant-based diet for 6 months. Okay, there are these researches that are there. So this is immense benefit. And so people are now very aggressive in spreading the benefits and the awareness of being on a plant-based diet. All right. Another very important factor is whatever food you have, even if you're a vegetarian, okay, we have a lot of processed food, a lot of packaged food, fast food, junk food, right? Plant-based diet is you do not have all those. All right. So major factor when being on a plant-based diet is that you have reduced inflammation in your body. And trust me, today the diseases that we all have, okay, your cancer, arthritis, obesity, diabetes, stress-related diseases, they are all because of increased inflammation in your body, increased pH in your blood, increased inflammation in your body. All right. And so it becomes very easy to control and reverse, start reversing the disease on a plant-based because it creates a very friendly environment. okay, the inflammation drops down. The moment your inflammation drops down, any treatment on your body really starts being very effective. Your aches, your pains, your swelling, your edema, they all come down. Okay, excess of that sodium is flushed out of your body. So can you imagine, okay, people on plant-based diets, okay, can get easily rid of their headaches and migraine. Okay. People suffering from cold, cough, sinuses, which are chronic, acute, leave your milk and just see. I'll tell you, my child, okay, he has severe sinusitis, but my mother believes in giving milk as she's so conditioned that, oh, milk is the best. You know, things were going beyond our limit, and I did not want him to, you know, have those pills and, you know, antihistamine pills to control his allergic sinuses. Having milk for next 1 week, 10 days at all, you are not doing that. And trust me, he was used to not be able to sit in the AC compartment. Like AC, jaise hi shuru hua, his sneezing starts. It used to become very difficult for me to stay in one room with him because it's so humid and hot, okay, and he doesn't allow the AC to go on. Okay, after 3 days of, you know, just cutting down on milk, okay, his sinuses just reduced, his cold cough, which was so chronic. I mean, I was kind of really tired. It just went away. And he is putting on the AC throughout the night and I'm amazed. Right? So this is something that I myself tried. Okay, I had migraine headaches. I reduced my milk. Okay, I used to have 2 times coffee. I just had 1 time now. And that also on different nut mills. And it has gone to drastically different level. So there are so many testimonies I can actually give which, you know, has been tried. So these are some definitely great benefits. And one of the major benefits which I feel all women would love to hear is it has amazing anti-aging properties. Okay. You know, our genes has telomeres, tails, okay, at the end of the DNA. And the plant-based diet, okay, it actually, you know, caps up that tail. So in short, it arrests your aging. So people on a plant-based diet are not only healthier, they look more younger too. Okay. And a classic example is Virat Kohli. Okay. He was a hardcore non-vegetarian, switched over to, plant-based. He's not a vegan, but he's on a plant-based diet. Okay, so you can see how healthy. So there are many myths surrounding it that, you know, they cannot put on weight and they cannot build up muscles. You know, what happens to the B vitamins and the iron? Trust me, it is all taken care. Of course, sometimes one needs, supplements, but natural supplements can be given. Fortified foods can be given. But yes, definitely it is taken care. Okay, what plant we should have? I mean, you're talking about the food sources? I think she's talking about the food sources. Probably. So your food sources is anything that comes from your plant, as I just mentioned earlier. Okay. So anything that is your dal, pulses, your grains, your vegetables, fruits, dry fruits, your nuts and oil seeds, your cold pressed oils, okay, your virgin oils, you can use all this. Okay, I had just mentioned in just at the start of the live. Okay, so yes, people having acne, okay, a lot of acne, try to go on a plant-based diet. You will have immense benefit. Just try it out and let me know. You can comment it. Okay, what happens to my calcium when I go on a plant-based diet? I don't have milk. Okay, so these are some of the questions I would like to address because I have been, you know, been the asked all this very frequently. In my post, in my account, in my post, I have mentioned food that are minus your animal products, that is calcium rich food. Go have a look at them. You can very easily include them. All your leafy vegetables, one serving gives you enough calcium. You don't need milk for that. Okay. And moreover, there was a survey done. There was this research also done where, you know, these corporate, the people working in the corporate, the officers, okay, they basically were given a plant-based diet, and there was a research done on them. Can you believe? At the end of 3 to 4 months, okay, the productivity increased by 40-45%. That is a remarkable difference, okay, because it's called as a sattvic food. Okay, plant-based diets are basically sattvic, and the energy flow of the sattvic diets are immense, and so the benefits are immense. Okay, I can go on and on with the plant-based diet because I'm a fan of it, okay, and I have kind of just adopted it. Okay, your thyroid, your PCOS, okay, strictly recommended to go on a plant-based diet. Arthritis, anybody has aches and pains, arthritis, because it's inflammation, it will go down. So anyways, there are a lot of benefits that can go on.
Yeah, we have a lot of things to talk, and we have one question, Ria, we can address that.
Yeah.
Thank you, first of all, for giving us so much of information on plant-based diets. Let's address this question is, when we go on a plant-based diet, from where do we get our vitamin B12?
Okay, so most of the sources which people think are that the vitamin B12 sources are only non-veg and milk products. That's not true. Okay, they are not the only sources. Okay, they are the sources but not the only sources. Okay, very good sources, your sprouts. Okay, when you have fermented products like idli, dosa, okay, your dhoklas, they all have B12. Okay, your sprouts, your fermented food products. Okay, now when there's something called as nutritional yeast. It is rich in vitamin B12. Okay, it's a powder form. You can sprinkle it on your soup, salad, on your dals. Dwani uses a lot of it in the recipe, so she can also, you know, guide. You can ask her where, how to use the nutritional yeast. Okay, so people basically on plant based, I do recommend nutritional yeast to them. All right. And another, I'll tell you one very simple way of incorporating. It may sound very funny, but it's very interesting. You know, if you do planting, if you do gardening, okay, you play with mud. You play with your mud. And you know, what happens is these bacteria, they enter your nail beds. And through your nail beds, enter your system. And they are apparently very good for you because they are a good source of vitamin B12. And, you know, we have forgotten to do that. Initially, yes, you know, there were people involved in a lot of gardening themselves. So it's a very natural way of gaining that. Yeah.
Great. Thank you so much, Ria. Quickly, we'll get to our last set of questions, which is, what are your 6 tips to go on a plant-based diet for a person who is on a plant-based diet?
Yeah. Very simple ones. First thing is, okay, never go all by itself. Go step by step. Change one meal at a time. Okay. And when? Now, someone who is going on a plant-based, tip 2, okay, replace your milk. Replace your curds. Don't cut them off. Unless and until you're so strong and will-powered that you will cut them off, never do that. Okay. So, nut milk options are available. Dwani has a lot of options. Guys, for recipes, you can always connect with her because I see a lot of recipes. She also, you know, takes care of the nutritional part. So, definitely you can, you know, contact her. You can make curds out of peanut. Okay, or what all other curds you can make, Dwani, you can always inculcate, right? So, yes, so always find a replacement for yourself. Yes, you can have almond milk, definitely. Why not? Or the nut milks, okay? Oats milk, rice milk, soya milk, amazing they are. Okay, just go ahead and have them. All right. The third tip. Okay, so when you're going on a plant-based, don't expect miracle in 15 days. The consistency, okay, will actually give you the result. You need to be patient. You need to trust the person who is basically recommending this to you and follow. Okay, if you are resistant, if you are not consistent, then of course the effects also will be like that. So expectation needs to be set right when going on a plant-based diet. Okay, fourth tip. If you are on a plant-based diet and you're still continuing to have your processed food, your refined food, your packaged and canned food, you will not get the desired results. Simple. So this has to be taken care of. Okay. And sixth and the last thing. Initially, you may, when you switch over to a plant-based diet, you may find that you're feeling tired and you're not feeling that great. Don't think this is because, you know, there will be a decrease, especially the ones on non-veg. Okay, there will be a decreased amount of B12 initially, iron and zinc in your body. So that will not make you feel very good. Hold on. Okay, be on it, be consistent. You know, within a week or 15 days, you will gain that back with double energy. All right? So you need to give that time. So these are my simple six tips to go on a plant-based diet. Okay? The entire agenda is to have fun when you're having plant-based, because nature is so full of different colors of vegetables and options of fruits and, you know, different plants which we have still not explored. So go ahead, explore all that.
Thank you so much, Riya. Thank you so much for addressing all our questions related to plant-based diet. And I think we have a lot of clarity now to go ahead with our plant-based diet. And we are ready to go. So thanks a lot, Riya.
Thank you. Thank you, Dhwani, for having me. It is always so great. And next Wednesday, we will be back again.
Same time.
Yes, same time.
Interesting episode.
Yes, with yet another interesting episode. And this time, we'll be dealing with, you know, one interesting topic where we'll be discussing different diseases. Okay? So be there. Switch on. Bye, see you. Thank you.
Thank you, Riya. Bye.
Bye.
So that's about it, guys. We discussed about some plant-based diet and foods for a plant-based diet. Do DM us if any questions. Mention in the comment section, how did you like the live? And stay tuned for another interesting and healthy episode at Oh Mind Your Body next Wednesday, 6 p.m. Signing off, Dhwani Gala, founder and owner at Oh Mind Your Body. Thank you. Bye-bye.